I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please stay tuned for a moment of silence.
My winter nights are taken up by static stress and holiday shopping traffic. But I close my
happy holidays, LC. Today is Monday, December 13th, 2021. And it is Monday. I'm Daniela.
And I'm Zinkley. We'll be right back with your daily announcements.
And I'm somewhere else, just like magic. My heart is a Christmas tree farm where the people would come to dance under sparkling lights, bundled up in their mittens and coats, and the cider would flow. And I just want to be there tonight.
Here are a few scholarships that will expire in December. Indiana State, the Gung Award Scholarship is for students planning to major in financial services or insurance and risk management. To be eligible to apply, students must be admitted as an incoming freshman to Indiana State University. Qualified students must possess two of the three following criteria: a cumulative grade point average of at least 3.5 on a 4.0 scale, an 1140 SAT combined critical reading and math, or 23 ACT, ranking in the top 15% of their senior class. Some other scholarships will be Senator Richard Lugar, awarded by University of Indianapolis, due on Wednesday, Foot Locker scholarship due on Friday, and Act 6 application due on Saturday. You may also search Naviance or contact Mr. Taylor in the guidance office for assistance.
The registration period for the Indianapolis Youth Leadership Academy is now open. The academy is a free one-week leadership development program for young adults who will be 15 through 18 years of age in June of 2022. Normally, our registration period has gone into the month of April. However, the class is filling up and there will be no guarantees we'll have seats available after February of 2022. All of information, including the dates, location, classes taught, contact information, and an auto-fill registration form can be found in the website, www.indyyouthleadership.com. If you have a positive attitude, a good work ethic, and a desire to succeed and understand how to become an effective leader, building teams, and being more productive in whatever career you might choose, this academy is for you. Take a look into the website and then consider your life as a follower or as a leader. Do something extraordinary. The University of Notre Dame pre-college programs offer exceptional students a true college experience. Earn a college credit through stimulating seminars, explore research with Notre Dame facility, and live in a residence hall community. There are various options in June, July, and August. Deadlines are January and February. Visit precollege.nd.edu or contact your guidance counselor for more information.
Attention all LC Bears! Do you have an interest in being a voice of a student body? Interest in having your stories published? Are you good at social media design, writing, or photography? Do you want to attend school events for free? Then being part of the Cub Reporter staff is a thing for you. The newspaper class meets during M7 and counts towards fine arts credit. We are in need of sports writers and general LC news writers. Please send a writing sample to nataliewatts@mlclt.org and let your counselor know you are interested in this diverse and creative class. We'd love to have you on our team. Today, we take our M5 and M6 finals. Tomorrow, we have G1 and G2. Don't give up now. Your final project or test could make a big difference in your grade.
Today's vocabulary word is palisade, a noun meaning a fence of stakes used for defense or a line of steep cliffs.
Did you know Mary Todd Lincoln was born on this date in 1887? She was the wife of America's 16th president, Abraham Lincoln. She became the White House's most criticized and misunderstood first lady, who led a controversial and tragic life to the end. Her mother died when she was 6 years old, after which her father remarried. Though he ensured she had the best of education, she did not get along with her stepmother. She was courted by Stephen Douglas of the Democratic Party, but she chose to marry Abraham Lincoln, a Republican. When her husband got elected as the President of America, she had to make a concerted effort to blend her Westerner upbringing with the predominantly Eastern culture of Washington, D.C. This was all the more difficult because her relatives were fighting for the Confederacy. She had four sons, of whom only one outlived her. Her husband was assassinated in her presence while they were witnessing a play in Ford's Theater. Though she was granted a pension and had an inheritance that was more than adequate, she had a phobia of being poor and behaved erratically. Her son ultimately confined her to an asylum from where she had to gain her freedom with the help of a lawyer. During her last days, she lived with her sister in Springfield, where she died and was buried beside her husband. She died in 1882 at the age of 63.
Celebrity birthdays: Taylor Swift is 32.
Jamie Foxx is 54.
Steve Buscemi is 64.
And Dick Van Dyke is 96.
This has been today's current.
Good luck on your finals.
Stay positive and test negative, Bears.